Hello friends, let us start with input tax credit, and this becomes your third unit in the syllabus given by Rani Chennamma University Belagavi. And this chapter becomes very important for your case study purpose. Okay, let us start. So input tax credit is not introduced along with the GST. It was also available earlier. So before the introduction of GST, the credit under indirect taxes was governed by CenVat credit. What is the CenVat? Central VAT credit. The way we had the VAT Act for the states, we had Central VAT also. So Central VAT credit rules 2004 was applicable for all the central taxes. Okay, for state taxes, VAT credit rules were applicable. VAT laws were applicable. So CenVat was applicable for input goods and capital goods purchased from across the country, while VAT legislations allowed to avail input tax credit for input goods and capital goods purchased from within the same state of that VAT law. Okay, for Karnataka VAT of Karnataka was applicable. For Maharashtra, VAT of Maharashtra was applicable. So similarly, if we had the 29 states earlier, then all those 29 VAT acts were applicable differently for different goods and services. These laws and rules were introduced to nullify the cascading effect. As you know, what is this cascading effect? Cascading effect is taxes on taxes, as you know, which was caused by various laws like central excise, like state excise, like service tax, like customs duty and VAT acts, etc. People used to pay taxes on taxes because of which there was hike in prices, and that was happening because of this cascading effect. So VAT laws and these rules were introduced to nullify that cascading effect, to make it zero. So the GST acts, means all these acts, CGST, SGST, OTGST and IGST, brought one nation, one market concept, where the flow of goods and services caused effectively, effortlessly and faster. ITC is the gist of GST. Please understand this point. GST said, one nation. For one nation, we have one market. It means you go in any state or any union territory, you will find the same rate of tax for same good or same service. This is the concept of one nation and one market. How does it help? It helps because the flow of input tax credit flows seamlessly. If you go to Karnataka, you have 18% on electronic goods. You go to Maharashtra or Goa, you go to Delhi, you go anywhere, you will find 18% on electronic goods only. So what will happen in this case is, the credit will flow seamlessly from supplier to the recipient. Okay, so ITC, input tax credit, is the gist of GST. Because of ITC, GST was introduced. Please understand, ITC is like heart or even brain of GST. Chapter 5 of CGST Act 2017, having sections 16 to 21, read with rules 36 to 45, deal with ITC and its provisions. So in CGST Act, we have so many chapters, and then we have section 16 to 21 for ITC. Also, we have rules, because everything cannot be given in the section. Every act is also accompanied with the rule. Okay, so the rule 36 to 45 deal with the ITC. Similar provisions are given in the SGST and UTGST for states. If you ask me, sir, what is the difference between CGST Act and SGST Act? It is just 1%. Wherever state wherever central is used over here, state is used here, right? In case of IGST, section 20 deals with the ITC and its provisions. Even for IGST, ITC is required, because for interstate transactions you need ITC. IGST deals with it, right? Hope this is understood. This is all introductory part. So let us understand ITC mechanism, input tax credit. First we will read this. Anand Traders sells goods to Bharat Enterprises for rupees 10,000 at 10% tax. I'm not speaking about GST, and therefore this rate I have taken 10%. Total amount is 11,000. Example: Anand issues an invoice to Bharat Enterprises for about transaction on same date, that is 15th May 2021. It means there was a transaction and invoice was issued on this point, on this date. There is Anand Trader and Bharat Enterprises. Anand Trader sells goods for rupees 10,000 plus taxes to Bharat, and Bharat Enterprises pays 10,000 plus 1,000 to Anand. Now Anand will file GSTR1 in the next month. Anand will file GSTR1 where this transaction is mentioned along with invoice number. Okay, so he files GSTR1 and mentions the transaction with invoice number. Why invoice number is needed and why to file this GSTR1? It is to communicate to the government, to tell the government that this transaction has happened between these two people. Okay, the same is reflected in GSTR2A of Bharat Enterprises. GSTR2 is for input supply, GSTR1 is for output supply. Now, as it is reflected in GSTR2A of Bharat Enterprises, Bharat Enterprises will approve this transaction. He will agree that yes, this transaction has happened in between Anand and Bharat only, right? Bharat, he approves the data, and the same data will reflect in GSTR2. GSTR2 is for input supplies. Now, as and when Bharat Enterprises files GSTR2, immediately ITC is made available to use for this Bharat Enterprises. Where it is applicable, where it is shown in the electronic credit ledger. There are three ledgers, as I have been telling you, there are three ledgers, one of which is electronic credit ledger, where ITC is seen, input tax credit is seen. These credit points will be used for future payment in the next month. Okay, so this ITC will be used. This is how he approves the transaction through GSTR2A. Hope this is understood and this concept is clear. If you still do not understand from this image, please comment below so that I can make some better graphics and show you how it is done. Let us go ahead. ITC availment versus ITC utilization. There is a difference between ITC availing and ITC utilization. Input tax credit availment refers to the situation where registered person has an option to get the ITC, which is available to him as on that situation. Section 16 to 19 of CGST Act deal with the ITC availment. Input tax credit utilization refers to the situation where registered person uses the ITC which was available to him. Section 49 of CGST Act 2017 deal with the ITC utilization. These are the two very simple differences. Let us understand with the example. When you visit the market with money in your pocket, the goods and services are available to you, right? When you visit the market with money, goods and services are available to you. You can purchase or you do not purchase. You have option, right? So immediately you enter the, whenever you immediately enter the market. But when you actually buy the goods and services with the money you have, you are utilizing the goods and services. Hope this is understood. There is another example. When registered person applies for ITC through proper channel, and government allots ITC to the person, this situation is ITC availment. And when the person actually uses the credit to pay the taxes in the next month, that is ITC utilized. So when government gives you ITC, that is ITC availment, you have availed the ITC, ITC is available for you. And when you actually utilize that, that is called as ITC, ITC utilization. Hope you have understood this point. Let us go ahead. There are some important definitions for this chapter, input tax credit. What is this input tax credit? Section 263 defines input tax credit means credit of input tax. See how simple this definition is. Just one line and you will get 2 marks. Input tax credit means taking credit of input taxes paid, taxes paid on input goods and services. Capital goods means what? Capital goods means this is defined under section 2 and subsection 19. Capital good means the value of which is capitalized in the books of account of the person claiming ITC and which are used or intended to be used in the furtherance of the business. This is called as capital good. Let us understand the input. Section 2 and subsection 59 defines input means any goods other than capital goods used or intended to be used by a supplier in the course of furtherance of a business. Please note, the term input essentially means input goods except capital goods. Okay, input does not include input services. Only input means we are speaking about input goods, because capital goods is defined differently, right? Now, input services. Section 2 of 60 says any service used or intended to be used by a supplier in the course of furtherance of business. This is the definition. So you might have observed one thing, which are used or intended to be used in the course of furtherance of business. As you can see, this line is repeated 3 times, used or intended to be used by a supplier in the course of furtherance of business, used or intended to be used by a supplier in the course of furtherance of business, right? So I thought to make you this image. This will define you these goods. Goods means inputs. Input means goods other than capital goods used or intended to be used in the course of furtherance of business. Capital goods means goods value of which is capitalized in the books of account of person claiming ITC, again used or intended to be used in the course of furtherance of business. And services means services used or intended to be used in the course of furtherance of business. This image will help you understand and by heart the definition very easily. You need not by heart, it is understood. It is very easy to remember, right? So what we have learned all today, see, we have started with the introduction. Earlier we had SENVAT credit, right? And to nullify the cascading effect, these laws were introduced. We had VAT credit for states and central VAT for central goods and services. And then GST was introduced because they wanted to charge every goods and service at one single rate, one nation and one market. And chapter 5 of CGST Act, which has section 16 to 21, and chapter 5 of CGST rules, rule 36 to 35, deal with the ITC, right? Similar provisions in SGST and UTGST acts. In case of IGST, section 20 deals with the ITC and its provisions. And then we have seen this ITC mechanism with this beautiful example, where I have also told you about GSTR1, GSTR2, GSTR2A, right? And then ITC availment versus ITC utilization, these two differences, right? And then definitions, input tax credit, capital goods, inputs and input services with this beautiful image, right? Hope this is understood and it is clear. We will start with eligibility and conditions, section 16 of ITC in the next video. Please stay tuned. For any doubts and clarifications, you can use the comment box below. Thank you. See you in next video.